Hello and welcome to this video about TypeScript translations with i18next. In this video, you will see how to introduce TypeScript translations within your TypeScript projects. Let's start with something simple. Your i18next setup is probably looking something like this. And somewhere in your code, you call the T function. i18next already furnishes TypeScript definitions for its API, like the T function. However, there is no type safety for translation keys yet. To address this, we now can create an i18next.d.ts file, preferably in a types folder. We need to declare the i18next module and override the custom type options with custom resources. As a first step, we can just import the existing JSON resources from our reference language and pass them via typeof to our resources object. Since we are also using a custom default namespace, we can also override the default NS property accordingly. That should already work. Let's check. Yes, it seems to work, and also the IntelliSense is shown. It works also with the namespace prefix. And another key. That's already great, but we can do better. Instead of importing all individual namespaces, we can generate a single resource file with the help of i18next resources for TS. We just need to install it and use the tuck command, for example like this. As input path, use the folder of your reference language, and as output path, a TS file next to the i18next custom definition file. The TS file has been generated, and now we can modify the i18next.d.ts file to use it. The type safety and IntelliSense is still working. Unfortunately, as long as a TypeScript issue is not addressed, automatic interpolation inference won't work if your translations are placed in JSON files. Only in TS files using sconst keyword or an interface in a DTS file. To work around this, let's make use of the interface command. For example, something like this. This generates an interface containing our reference resources. Let's delete the old file and use this definition file instead. Now, also the past interpolation properties are type safe. Let's try some plural keys. Just run the interface command again, and voila! And also the fallback namespace handling should work. We just have to define the fallback NS option. What about the React app? Same preconditions. No type-safe translations yet. So let's create an i18next.d.ts file like before. The resources are lazy-loaded via i18next HTTP backend plugin, so we need to adapt the script argument here. Again, install i18next resources for TS and prepare the script. Execute the script, import the DTS file, and that's it. The translations are type-safe. The type checking is also working in the trans component of React i18next. Passing the desired namespace via useTranslation is also reflected in the type checks and in the IntelliSense, also with multiple namespaces. There is also a way to keep the translations completely separate from your code repository while maintaining type safety. Let's use this project for example. It uses the i18next locize backend to lazy load the translations from the locize CDN. There are no local translation resources here. At runtime, we load the translations directly from the locize CDN. So during development, we need to download the translation resources first. We do so with the locize CLI. Then, as usual, we prepare the i18next.d.ts file. Now we can prepare our download script that will download the translations for our reference language to a temporary folder. Install the i18next resources for TS module and prepare the interface script. As input, use the temporary folder. And a last script that will combine the other two scripts and also cleans up the temporary folder. That's it! The translations are separated from our code repository, and at the same time, we maintain type safety. Thank you very much for your attention, and happy coding!